Welcome once again to Delight Channel as we continue our conversation on life-life balance. Last week, I focused on why this concept is very important. To the individual, it has a lot to do with your happiness, and to the business, looking after your employees and helping them find life-life balance is good business. If you missed those two videos, please go back and watch so that you can be educated. But this week, we are flipping the coin and we are saying, if you choose not to heed and you neglect paying attention to life-life balance, how does that affect you and what are the consequences of a life that is out of balance? For the individual, the very, very first thing you need to be aware of is that lack of life-life balance is going to affect your health. I am not just talking about the physical, I'm talking about the emotional, I'm talking about the relational. Remember that World Health Organization defines a healthy person not just in terms of the physical health, but also in terms of the emotional health. So when you see somebody who is out of balance, or whose balance is out of whack, what are you likely going to find? You are going to find a lot of stress. They will be overwhelmed. They are always complaining. There is so much to do. They are aware that other parts of their lives are suffering, but they are not able to do much about it, and that puts a lot of pressure on them. And one thing about stress is that stress damages the entire body system, because certain hormones, certain neurotransmitters that are negative and destructive will be present in your body for far too long a period. I mean, some measure of stress is good for the system. That is what teaches us the fight or flight response that we need to give to situations. But where you are now perpetually under stress, what will happen? It will lead to strain. And then if you're not managed, is going to lead to snap. Things are going to start snapping in your system. So you are going to have a lot of sicknesses because your body is overworked, the chemicals in your body are not working as they should, organs begin to fail. As a matter of fact, science is beginning to find out that many of the sicknesses that are manifesting in physical form, they have psychological roots. And that's what they call the psychosomatic sicknesses. It is critical that you realize that your living, your staying healthy, can actually depend on whether you're able to find balance or not. It's also the same on the emotional side. You find out that those who have their life out of balance are very challenged emotionally. They are very unhappy. They can easily fall into depression. Some can have borderline personalities. It affects you in very deep, fundamental ways. And may I add that these sicknesses that we are talking about are better prevented than cured. Imagine somebody who, as a result of stress, gets obese, who, as a result of lack of balance, then suffers a stroke. It's very hard to restore back to normal functioning. Is a lot cheaper, a lot easier to prevent that from happening rather than to now want to be finding a remedy when they have happened. And it's not limited to that. You also find manifestation in sexual health, where you find the woman unable to respond in terms of rigidity. You have the man unable to be sexually productive and active at home simply because this lack of balance just drains him out. By the time he gets in, he's completely drained, exhausted, either from work done or from work not done. Even the immune system is affected. People who are stressed out, they're always falling sick. Again, because of the mess that their emotional state is and all the chemicals in their body. And if it is not taken care of, eventually you find them burning out and sometimes even dying without any justification for it. Therefore, this issue of life-life balance has very, very grave implications if it is not pursued. Of course, we've also spoken about the business side, that when you don't do it, pure simple, you lose people, you lose productivity, you lose profit. That's it. If you do not pay attention to it, I say it again, as a business, you lose people, you lose productivity, and you lose profit. And third, but certainly not the least, is that your significant relationships are affected when you now find a situation where either you are sick or you are unable to be available to your family, to your children, to your spouse. Over time, you begin to suffer from the lack of those social interactions. And as it is very obvious to almost all of us, and I hope you are one of them, is the fact that we are social animals. We were not built or created to walk or live as an island. When your marriage breaks down because you are not there, when your relationship with your children breaks down because you are not there, when your relationship with your friends breaks down because you are not there, when you are unable to maintain your relationship with God because you are not there, when your friends can't see you, your clubs can't see you, then for God's sake, are you now going to live as an island on your own? And how is that going to sound? Therefore, it is critical that you get this gist deep into your mind that this life-life balance we are talking about is not a nice to have. It is not something I do if I choose, or when I think about it, I will try and find time for it. You got to bake it into the architecture of your life. And I do not care where you are in your journey right now. It's never too late to start. If you've missed it so far, stop where you are, check your baggage, check your structure, and make sure you are here next week, because we will then start talking about what are the factors that you need to take care of and how do you really go about it. We are now nearing the landing point, so I'm sure you don't want to miss it. And if there's something you'd like us to cover before we land, don't hesitate to send it in. And until I see you next week, I'd like to drop the anchor here and remind you that T-Mac is still my name. The channel you are watching is called DLI, Development, Empowerment, and Leadership Initiative. And don't ever, 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 ever forget that all we are trying to do on this channel is what? Make a little difference. I'm sure I'll see you next week as we now begin to approach landing. Until then, have a wonderful time out there. Bye.